Hello students, welcome to our next class of advanced maths. So in our last classes we have done how to convert, I have taught you how to convert exponential form to logarithm form and logarithm form to exponential form, and also how to find the value of y at any log. Okay, so today we will be doing properties of log, which are very important to solve the sums. Okay, these properties are very important. If you know all these properties, then we can easily do all the sums. And these properties are very important. Okay, so let's start properties of log. First property is what? Property one is what? Log a base a equal to 1. Okay, so log of any number at the same base is equal to 1. Okay, so how we'll get it? Let us take log a base a is equal to x. So this one, what we can write? A to the power x equal to a. So what will be your x value? X will be 1, right? X will be 1. So we will get log, we have told log a base a equal to x, so log a base a equal to 1. We are getting this property 1, okay? So you have understood that log of any number at the same base will be equal to 1. For example, log 2 base 2 equal to 1, log 3 base 3 equal to 1, okay? Any log of any number on the same base, log of any number on the same base, okay, will be what? 1, okay? Log 5 base 5 equal to 1, okay, understood? So, what is property 1? Log of any number on the same base will be equal to 1. Now, property number 2, log 1 base a is equal to 0. Okay, so log 1 at any base will be 0. Okay, log 1 at any base will be equal to 0. So how? Let us take again log a base 1 equal to x. Again convert it into exponential form, a to the power x equal to 1. So when will be 1? When the power is x equal to 0, then only 1 comes. Suppose 5 to the power 0 is 1 we write. 2 to the power 0 is 1 we write. So, log 1 at any base. Log 1 at any base will be what? 0. X will be 0. Okay. So, suppose we write log 5, 1 equal to what? 0. How? 5 to the power 0 is equal to 1. Right? 5 to the power 0 is equal to 1. If we convert this in exponential form, so 5 to the power 0 is equal to 1. So when x equal to 0, then only 1 comes. So log 1 base a is equal to 0. That means log of 1 at any base. Log of 1 at any base will be 0. Example what? I'll give you some other examples. Log of 1 base 3 equal to also 0. Log of 1 base 2 is also 0. Log of 1 base 10 is also 0. Okay. So, what is the conclusion? What is the property? Log of 1 at any base. Remember, log of 1 at any base is equal to 0. Our property 1 was log of any number at the same base. Log of any number at the same base is equal to 1. And second property is log of 1 at any base is equal to 0. Then I have showed you how to do, how to prove it. You can take this one is equal to x. Then if we convert it into exponential form, then a to the power x will be equal to 1. And when 1 will come, when x equal to 0, when the power is 0, then only 1 comes. So, here are some examples also I have shown you. Log of 1 base 3 will be 0. Log of 1 base 2 will be 0. Log of 1 base 10 will be 0. Okay? Now, property 3. This is called product property. Okay? Product property. So, log m into n base a equal to log m base a plus log n base a. also here. If two numbers are multiplied and we are taking log of them, then we can split both of them. Okay? And in middle there will be addition. Okay? Understood? If two numbers are multiplied and we are taking log of them, then both of them can be split. Understood? We can split both of them. So log m into n base a, we are multiplying two numbers, and how can we split it? Log m base a plus log n base a. Okay? Understood? So suppose let us take this one. Log of a to the power m equal to p. Then this one, how can we write in exponential form? Let us prove it, how it comes. Okay, so this one we can write m equal to a to the power p. Okay, and this one log n base a equal to q. This one how can we write? N equal to a to the power q. Okay, so if we multiply these two, multiply this one give one, this one give two, and if we multiply equation 1 and 2, then multiplying equation 1 and 2, multiplying equation 1 and 2, m into n equal to a into p into a to the power p into a to the power q. So this one how can we write? m n and this one, if it is multiplied then the powers are added, if it is multiplication then the powers are added, we know. So a to the power p plus q. Now if we take log of this, log mn a base a, log mn base a equal to p plus q, right? So log mn, m into n base a, and p is what? P is, we have taken log m base a, log m base a plus q is log n base a, right? So see, we have proved it that when log of any number, we are taking log of any number, two numbers when multiplied, so we can split both of them. Understood? When two numbers are multiplied and we are taking log of that two numbers, then we can split both of them. Remember, we can split both of them. Okay, so we have proved it. Let me show you some examples. Okay, suppose log 3, 2 into 5. This is mn, right? 2 into 5 is 10. How can we split it? See, log 2 base 3 first plus log of 5 base 3 we can write. We have splitted it. Okay. So, if it is like this, log 6 base 2, then how can we write it? Log of, first of all, 2 base 2 plus log of 3 base 2. 2 3 is 6. So, we have splitted them. Understood? So, this property is very important. Okay. This property is very important. To solve most of the questions, we need this property. So, remember this property very nicely. Okay, we need this property most of the time. Remember it. Now, property 4. This is what? Log m divided by n base a equal to log m base a minus log n base a. So, these two, that first log, property 3 and property 4 is same like the property of exponents. When it is multiplication, then there will be addition, okay? The power will be added, and when it is division, then the power will be subtracted. So, same for log also, okay? When it is addition, then we have added, and when it is subtraction, we will find the difference, okay? We will do difference. Now let's prove it how log m divided by n base a will be equal to log m base a minus log n base a. Same like before, you will take let log m base a equal to p, then log n base a equal to q. Okay, so this one will be what? M equal to a to the power p and n equal to a to the power q. Okay, so if we divide, now what we will do? We will divide, because this is not product, this is division. So m divided by n equal to a to the power p divided by a to the power p divided by a to the power q. Okay, so this one will be a to the power p minus q. M divided by n equal to a to the power p minus q. Now take log of this, log m divided by n base a will be equal to p minus q. Now log of m divided by n base a equal to p is what? Log of m base a minus q is log of n base a. Okay, so we have got log of m divided by n base a is equal to log of m base a minus log of n base a. Okay, so let me show you one example. So log of 2 and 2 divided by 3, how can we write it? Log of 2 base 2 minus log of 3 base 2. Okay, so this is the example. Okay, you have understood property 3 and property 4 are same, only when it is division we write minus and when it is multiplication we write plus. So now next property is property 5, and what does it say? That log of m to the power n base a will be equal to n log m to the base a. Okay, have you understood what this property says? Log of m to the power n base a will be equal to n log m base a. So what does it means? That the power here will come as outside as multiplication. We will multiply the power like this. Okay, so for example log of 3 square base 2, how we can write? This one will come as multiplication here. So 2 log of 3 base 2, like this we will write. Understood? I'll show you another example. Log of 3 cube base 5. So this one the power will go as multiplication outside. Okay, and what we can write? 3 log of 3 base 5. Okay, so property 5 is what? Very easy. Only the power here will go outside as multiplication. Okay, so property 6 is what? Log a base c equal to log a base b divided by log of c base b. So this is called base changing rule, and this is a very important property. All of us should know this very well. Okay, suppose many times we need to make the base same. So suppose we have to make this one the base b, to make base b. So what does it say? This says that the number for which we are taking log will come on the numerator along with the new base b, and the old base, this is your old base, will come on the denominator along with the new base you are taking. Understood? Again I am repeating. This one is what? What does it say? What does this property say? That the number for which we are taking log, and we have to make this one, we have to make the base C, base B, remember. Okay? So now the number for which we are taking log will come on the numerator along with the new base, and the old base will come on the denominator along with your new base. So this is called base changing rule. So suppose let us prove it. Let log of a base c equal to x. So this one what we can write? A equal to c to the power x with the new base we have taken. Okay, so log of a base b equal to log of c to the power x base b. Okay, so this one what we can write? Log of a base b will remain same, and this one, this is property which one? Property 5 we have done. this one will come, the power will come as multiplication. So x log of c base b. Okay, so see here, now we can find the value of x here. So x equal to log of a base b divided by log of c base b, and your x is what? Log of a base c equal to log of a base b divided by log of c base b. Okay, so we have made the base same here, remember? So to make the base same, we use this property. This is called base changing rule. Okay, again I am repeating it. What to do to make the base same? See, the number for which we are taking log will come in the numerator along with the new base, and the old base will come in the denominator along with the new base. For example, log of 3 base 2. So we have to make the base same. Okay, so suppose I am taking log base 5 I am taking, then log of what we will write here? Log of the number for which we are taking log will come in the numerator. So we are taking log of 3. This will sit in the numerator and the old base will go on the denominator. Okay, along with the base 5. So this one. So log of 3 base 2 is equal to log of 3 base 5 divided by log of 2 base 5. Again, if I make another base, log of 3 base 10 divided by log of 2 base 10. Like this it will go on. Log of 2 base 3 divided by log of 2 base 2. So this is base changing rule. Okay, have you understood? So these are all the properties we need. These are most important properties, remember. If we know all these properties, we can easily solve our logarithm. Okay, so today in our class we have learned all the properties of logarithm, and so this I told you that these properties are very important to solve our sums. Okay, so in our next class we'll be using all these properties to solve our sums.